Hey guys, so finally the FIFA World Cup is on and running. It's been such a long wait, and I have really good memories of the FIFA World Cup. Like last time the FIFA World Cup happened, me and my friends met to watch the finals together, and we didn't think it was possible because the finals was at midnight, and there was an English exam the very next day. However, for the first time, our school did something spectacular. They postponed the English exam because they apparently wanted us to watch the final and learn something. Obviously, this was nonsense. I mean, what kind of reason is that? I personally think the only reason is because they want us to think that the school actually cares about us. But anyway, we met, we were all going high, and then one of us, he started saying, "Random fact, bro, random fact," in like some really weird accent, which I can't imitate. So he started telling that, and he started telling some stupid facts. Like, he was like, "Bro, this is the 20th time the World Cup is happening." Yeah, and that's like the 20th time you told me that, so shut up. Well, anyway, and then the match was starting, and then all the players were walking onto the field, and we felt like we were walking onto the field. We were feeling so proud as if we were playing the final and trying to win it for our team. And suddenly the current goes. We went berserk. It was maddening. We called BESCOM and they were like, "The current has gone due to technical reasons." That's the same lame excuse they always give. And BESCOM is horrible. They give you current and then suddenly it goes off. And trust me, this is better than no current because I actually have a theory to prove it. It's called a chicken wing theory. Just imagine there's a plate of chicken wings lying in front of you. And you can take one bite, but you can't eat the whole thing. Is that better? Or is having no chicken wing in front of you to tempt you better? You only decide. So well, yeah. So we were damn depressed and stuff. And finally, 2 hours later, the current came back. And then we saw, and then we checked the score. We were like, okay. We all thought the match would be over in 90 minutes, but no. We saw, and the match had gone to extra time. We went mad. We started shouting like we had won the World Cup. And finally the match started, and then came the moment where Mario Götze scored. And me being an Argentina fan, I went mad. I was out of control. I started shouting random stuff like, "Bro, Mario Götze, he's a goat. That goat, sir, he should not be allowed onto the pitch. How is he allowed onto the pitch?" And then I started saying stuff like, "He was 10 meters offside. It was so clear," which is actually kind of weird to say, thinking now, because actually, he was more close to being 10 meters onside than 10 meters offside. But anyway, the match ended, and then I also started saying stuff like, "Bro, that referee, he's a blind duck, that fool," and stuff like that. So anyway, the match ended, and I was sad. But anyway, it was a good memory. And now I come to the end of the story. And yes, this was a story. This actually did not happen. Surprise, huh? What actually happened is the school did postpone our exam, but my parents were like, "School is more important than the FIFA World Cup final." But I don't understand how something that happens daily is more important than something that happens once in 4 years. But anyway, so I couldn't watch. And the most funny and ironic part about this is I anyway had to miss school next day because I had wheezing. So I stayed home. That was the worst part of it all. But anyway, that's what actually happened. I didn't get to watch the final.